Hi, today I'm going to take you through an assessment summary of a student using the PM Benchmark software. After you have completed an assessment, it will direct you to the summary section. From the top of screen, it will provide you with the ability to change the student's PM reading level. This student did a great job. Is he ready for the next level? Select a new level for this student or close this message. We are going to move the student from a level 2 to a PM level 3. From there, on the right-hand side, we can click Apply New Level, and that student's profile has now been updated. On the left-hand side of screen, it will provide you with assessment details, with the book and level that was just read, the running words, the assessor, the date on which it was completed, accuracy percentage, retelling score, comprehension score, words read, and miscues and self-corrections. Below that is the reading level based on the calculations provided in the assessment. Please note that this bar is also able to be changed manually if necessary. Below that is the summary tab, which we're currently at right now. Also, there is a recommendations tab and a print tab, which we'll explain in a moment. On the summary section, it provides you with reading behaviors, retelling, comprehension, and reading record. It provides you with the knowledge and skills that the student has demonstrated during the assessment, and same for strategies and fluency. Additional notes can be added at this time. The next tab we'll select is retelling, and again, it provides you with what the student has demonstrated during the assessment with the ability to add additional notes. Clicking comprehension will provide you with the literal and inferential questions during the assessment and the student's answers. The last thing we can view in the summary section is the reading record, which will show you the student's actual reading record. On the right-hand side of screen is the log button, which will change the layout of the reading record, where you can see the miscues and self-corrections. We can refer to the previous screen by clicking text. The next tab we're going to select is recommendations. This provides you with brief recommendations for future development of the student in reading behaviors, retelling, and comprehension. As the student has performed well in the reading behavior section, in knowledge and skills, it will not provide you with any feedback. In strategies, it provides you with explicitly teach the student how to and a variety of different methods moving forward. Again, fluency was well done by the student, so there is no recommendations for future development at this point in time. The next section will be retelling. And again, this provides you with explicitly teach the student how to and a variety of methods moving forward with the student. The last one is comprehension, where you can see additional information provided for you. The last section is the print section. We're able to provide a PDF generated file, which can be printed out or sent via email to additional staff members. It allows you to export this assessment, and we can select from three different categories: summary, recommendations, and reading record that you want to export onto your file. We can do this by clicking the tick box next to each category, and we can also break down even further and customize the assessment that we see fit. In today's example, we're going to select all areas. Then on the bottom right-hand side of screen, click the Export Assessment button. This will generate a PDF, which you can open up and review. Again, this can be downloaded onto your computer and printed out or sent via an email to additional staff members. It provides you with the student's information, the PM level that was just assessed with the title and the level, the assessor. It provides you with the retelling section, comprehension section, reading behaviours, as well as the reading record in both views. From there, we can click back and it returns you to the assessment summary main page. Please also note that clicking the person icon on the top right-hand side of screen will take you directly to the student's profile where you can edit additional information if required. To return to the home screen, click the hamburger icon, click assessments, and that will return you to the main screen. Please also note that you can access assessment summaries if they appear on the recently completed assessment section, or you can go into the student's profile in assessment history and select the assessment you'd like to look at. And that's accessing the assessment summary section of the PM Benchmark software. Thank you.